therefore as an antidote to jealousy. Then the fifth meritorious action is to supplicate that the wheel of the Dharma be continuously turned. Reflecting upon how to an ordinary person like one's own self, with all the marks of ignorance and unawareness, how the Dharma has infused clarity and wisdom, and that whatever little basic goodness that we are able to generate, it is due to the compassion and the kindness and the wisdom of the Dharma and the source of the Dharmas, and therefore wishing the same for all sentient beings and requesting and supplicating that the wheel of the Dharma be continually turned for the future generations and for all sentient beings. Thinking in this way is considered to being the fifth branch offering, known as supplicating the wheel of the Dharma to be continued. And in making this kind of an expression, it is said to be the antidote to ignorance. And therefore, prostration breaks down the dominance of arrogance. Offerings, in the same way, lets go of the stronghold of attachment and stinginess. Confession is an antidote to anger. Joyfulness is an antidote to jealousy. Requesting the wheel of the Dharma is the antidote to ignorance. And then further knowing that for the wheel of the Dharma to be turned, great bodhisattvas and enlightened beings must continuously remain. And therefore, supplicating for the great beings to continually remain is the sixth branch offering. And that is then the antidote to non-awareness. Whenever in your mind you understand the value and the profound truth of the Dharma, ignorance immediately begins to dissolve. In the same way, when you really realize how essential it is for the bodhisattvas to continually remain, it again immediately in your own mind allows you to recognize the value of developing awareness and to truly hold as being precious the teachings and the instructions that one has received in cultivating realization of one's own fundamental nature of mind. So therefore, the sixth branch offering of supplication for the enlightened beings to remain then is the antidote to non-awareness. And then the seventh branch offering is dedication of merit, and that is the antidote to self-absorption or self-cherishing. Dedicating whatever merit through the day, any good things that you have done, any moments of awareness you've been able to develop, any practice or remaining within the realization of the true nature that you've been able to cultivate, and any merit that has arisen from prostrating, offering, confessing, joyfulness, supplicating, and requesting for the enlightened beings to remain, may it be dedicated for all sentient beings, and then dedicating the merit again, whatever you have, to all this countless, innumerable sentient beings, is the perfect antidote to lessening, self-cherishing, and thinking only about your own self. So these are called the seven branch offerings, perfect antidotes to these seven kleshas or negativities: arrogance, attachment, anger, jealousy, ignorance, non-awareness, and self-absorption are the cause of adversities. So in order to transform adversities into the path of awakening, let go of these. And in their state, instead of these, exercise meritorious activities of prostrations, offering, purification, joyfulness, requesting the wheel of the Dharma to be turned, supplicating the bodhisattvas to remain, and dedication of merit. In this way, you don't have to spend a dollar and yet be generous. You don't have to go anywhere and be able to accumulate merit. You can sit on your cushion and you can still generate tremendous merit for yourself. And that then becomes the basis of transformation of adverse circumstances into the path of awakening.